Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be talking about how to improve your coding skills. As a software developer, this is something that I'm always striving to do, is improve the way I code, my thought process for coding, to achieve better code at the end of the day and essentially make my life and other developers who might be touching my codes lives easier. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for being amazing, wonderful. You know, I love you all so much. Okay, let's get right into it. I'm sure there is no surprise here, but there is such a difference between an average or okay programmer or developer versus someone who really takes it to the next level. And this is something that you really have to choose if you want to be, you know, excel at coding and really make your career go to the next level, which I think if you take some of these tips into hand and really apply them to your daily coding, you're going to really progress in your career, in your business, anything of the above, way quicker than if you're just kind of okay with being okay. And today I want to share with you some of those tips that will really help take your coding to the next level. The number one tip I have for you if you want to take your code to the next level and really improve it is to read others' code. I know this kind of sounds strange and maybe it's something that sounds kind of boring because it doesn't involve actual coding, but reading other people's code who are better than you or who have different kind of principles applied to coding is a great way to improve your coding skills. My favorite way to do so, and this actually was something I did when I first started to learn how to code and still do now as a developer, is to go on GitHub, look at open source projects and see how other people are coding. This gives you a sense of maybe finding different solutions to different problems or implementing different pieces of code in ways that you haven't thought of yet. This gives you a sense of looking into ways and solutions of improving code or implementing code in different ways that you might have not even have thought of. Maybe some code that you read on open source is actually worse than the code you would write, but it's a great way to apply your thinking skills and logic as to, okay, I see this person solved it this way, how would I solve it? I also want to share with you some open source GitHub projects that are great examples of ones to look up or look at if you want to read some code. Okay, I'm going to put up on screen here some of the names and I will link them down below. There's always different GitHub resources or GitHub open source projects that are trending depending on what's very popular at the moment. And it's always great to make sure that you are reading code from a very up-to-date open source project to ensure you are reading code that is the latest and the greatest. Tip number two that I really want to talk about is practice. And you're probably like, Tiffany, that's the lamest tip I've ever heard, but just let me explain, hear me out. A lot of times when we are learning something new or we are wanting to apply skills that we're just learning to our coding practices, maybe you are learning a new library or framework, we just kind of watch a tutorial after tutorial, maybe you read a lot about it, but at the end of the day, do not get stuck in what is called tutorial hell, where essentially you just keep on doing tutorial after tutorial. In reality, you know, it's important to take a tutorial and have a strong basic understanding of what it is you are learning, but then you really need to take those skills and start practicing. A question I get asked all the time is, well, Tiff, what do I practice on? If I'm not someone who is actively doing what I'm learning at work, where do I go to practice? And for me, the best thing I always say to do is build a project you are passionate about. This might be you are passionate about, I don't know, cooking, or for me it was skincare, or you're passionate about fashion, anything else outside of, you know, maybe your coding and tech life that you are passionate about, try building a project for that or build something that will solve a problem you are interested in. This makes it actually fun to set time aside and start coding on your free time, and you get to practice the skills that you are putting to use. Also, this is a great way to kind of implement my tip number one where I said read others' code. If you're building a project on the side and you see the way others are coding, in the space of your own kind of project, you can really make it that you can mess up. The code doesn't have to be perfect. No one else is really going to be using it at that moment. So why not try some of the things that you saw others were doing when reading code? Okay, coming in at number three, before I even get there, I have a little confession to make to you. I used to be, and still am sometimes, which I'm really embarrassed to say, a developer that if it works, it's good enough. which is horrible. Do not become one of those developers. But I think we've all been there to some degree, or at some points we just kind of say, it works, it's good enough, I've worked on this for so long, let's move on. And of course there is that fine line of you want to make something perfect and work on it until it is the best it can be and the code is the best it can be. But there's also that fine line of spending your entire life on this one piece of code because it's never going to be perfect. So I think it needs to be a little give and take, but I definitely have times where I'm just like, okay, it works, move it, ship it, we're done with it. And probably when I shouldn't have done that. And I think we've all been there. Or maybe I'm saying that to make myself feel better. But at the end of the day, what I'm trying to say is for tip number 3, set aside time for refactoring. Refactoring is huge and you can learn so much from setting some time aside specifically for refactoring your code. When you take time to refactor your code, you are going to find ways to improve your code, to see what others have done, maybe read some articles of how to improve your code. So that next time you're doing something similar, you'll just go right into the way you did it the first time with refactoring. And this is something that I've recently started to implement in my kind of coding workflow, is to really set some time aside that this time is for refactoring. And your code can always be better than it currently is, so it's never going to be wasted time, but it's important to actually set that time aside. Coming in at number 4 is to engage in the computer science and really tech community. And this is a great way if you are engaged and active in the community, especially online, to ensure you are staying up to date on current trends and what's really happening in the tech industry. A great way that I love to do just this, and it's just from the comfort of your home, is through Slack communities. There are so many great communities on Slack, from, you know, women in tech to people who code in React to, I don't know, literally everything under the sun you can think of, there's probably a community or Discord channel for that. And it's a great way to engage with others who have similar interests and also see what's kind of, what they're working on, what frameworks are really popular, and give you a sense of where everyone else is at and everyone's kind of, the industry is headed. You kind of can get through the whispers and what everyone's saying, you get a really good understanding as to what trends are coming up, what frameworks are very popular. And along the way too, I think a lot of people find ways to improve their code by listening to what others have to say about code. I'll link some great Slack channels down below that I really enjoy being part of in the tech community. And even through different resources like newsletters or blogs, like, I don't know, there are so many great ways to really keep up to date. And I think in order to improve your coding skills, you really need to do just that by keeping up to date as to what's trending, you know, what's coming down the pipeline, because then you can apply that to your code to improve it. Number 5, the last thing I want to talk about today, one of the biggest tips, is to look under the hood. A lot of times when we are learning how to code, we don't really, especially if you're self-taught or went to a boot camp, you don't really explore what's going on under the hood. Why do we choose to use JavaScript instead of Python? Why do we choose to use React instead of Vue? Why do we choose to use Node? The whys about why we are doing what we are doing. We focus a lot on the hows, how to use JavaScript, how to use React. But once you get past the hows, kind of take a step back and focus on the why. Why am I learning this? Why did I choose JavaScript? What is JavaScript? What are the benefits? What are the pros? What are the cons? And if you can be a developer who really knows the whys, I think that automatically takes you to the next level as a developer. Because if you know the whys, you can really understand. You can switch quicker to other programming languages, to other frameworks, because you know the pros and cons of each. Now, I'm not telling you to know every single programming language pros and cons, but the ones you do know, take time to understand the whys as to why they are popular, why people use them, what are the pros and what are the disadvantages. I love to read up on this and kind of even talk to, if you don't have anyone to, you know, speak to about this, even do the rubber ducky method, where you just talk to yourself out loud, literally, and just say, okay, you know, these are some pros here, these are some cons here. And having an understanding of the language you are using or the framework will really make you a better developer and really improve your coding skills, because you know what is going on. You're not just coding to code. Okay, those are my 5 tips to improving your coding skills. I guarantee these will help you improve your coding skills, speaking from firsthand experience for myself. I hope you found this video helpful and valuable. Make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Give this video a thumbs up And please leave in the comments other videos you want to see. What are some questions you have? What are some topics you want me to cover? I love reading your comments. I do my best to reply to every single comment. So please leave what you want to see from me. Thanks, everyone.